Hello everyone, this is Dr. E, and for today we're going to be talking about a special type of quadrilateral that is parallelogram, and we're going to discuss about the conditions that make a quadrilateral a parallelogram. We have different types of quadrilateral, and one of them is a parallelogram. And we have special quadrilaterals like rhombus, square, rectangle, trapezoid. But for today, we're going to be more specific on parallelograms, and we're going to be working on the conditions that will make a quadrilateral a parallelogram. So what are these conditions? But first, let's define what a parallelogram is. And a parallelogram, by definition, is a quadrilateral, which means a polygon with four sides, with both pairs of this quadrilateral of opposite sides being parallel. So that is the basic definition of a parallelogram. So let's draw our parallelogram, and to satisfy the definition with our visual, let's identify the parallels or pairs of opposite sides that are considered parallel in this quadrilateral. So the opposite sides right here are considered parallel because we're seeing that little triangle symbol or arrow symbol, however shape you want to consider it. So since we have the same number of arrows on top and the bottom, that means the opposite sides are parallel in this parallelogram. And the other side, we have those diagonal lines that we are seeing, and since they have the same number of arrows or triangles, that means that those sides are also parallel to each other. So that means our quadrilateral that you are seeing here right now is considered to be a parallelogram because it satisfies the basic definition of a parallelogram, which is both pairs of opposite sides should be parallel. Now, there are parallelograms who have special properties, and we're going to be working on that today. And we're going to be using their sides, their angles, and their diagonals to define and consider a quadrilateral to be a parallelogram. So here are the six conditions that we're going to be working on. One, both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. And how are we going to identify that in a parallelogram? So in symbol form, let's say I have here a parallelogram, and this is considered to be a quadrilateral, not yet a parallelogram, but if I'm going to put a symbol here that satisfy condition number one, both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. So that means this side right here should be parallel, which is this particular symbol. And this symbol right here is denoting that this sides right here are also parallel. And this is condition number one in this definition that we are working on right now. So this is our parallelogram. If the opposite sides are considered to be parallel, which is true in this particular case, then we know that condition number one is satisfied. So this is considered to be a parallelogram. Now, we know that this parallelogram is already this quadrilateral is already a parallelogram. But for the sake of discussion, let's visualize the other six conditions that we have here. The second one, it says here that one pair of opposite sides is parallel and at the same time congruent. And to be able to show that condition in our parallelogram with the hopes that my marker is working. So here is a parallelogram. So let's say this is a parallelogram. Forgive my drawing, but just to identify and visualize condition number two, one pair of opposite sides should be parallel and at the same time congruent. So this is how you denote parallel lines. So we have the arrows. Arrow. This is parallel and at the same time congruent. So that means this line right here They need to be congruent to each other. So that is the symbol that we use for congruency for lines. And another visual that you can share right here is knowing that those two lengths of our lines are congruent with that little symbol right here. That means that we satisfied condition number two, which is one pair, just one pair, it doesn't need to be both of them, are parallel and congruent. Therefore, they will be considered as parallelogram. And for condition number three, both pairs of opposite sides are congruent. So both pairs of opposite sides are congruent. So let's use this parallelogram right here to denote that definition or description. So that means they have the same measurement for those two sides that you're seeing. The blue, is it blue or green? Blue. So that blue line right there is the measurement of those opposite sides, and they are congruent. So therefore, if both pairs of opposite sides, the horizontal and the diagonals, are both the same or they're congruent to each other, then it will be considered as parallelogram. So that is condition number condition number three. And for condition number four, both pairs of opposite angles are congruent. So we are seeing that the corners that you are seeing right now are the same angle measurement. So it needs to be both opposite corners. So the first corners, opposite corners are already congruent. And we also need to know and make sure that the other opposite corners are also congruent or the same angle measurement. Therefore, we'll be able to satisfy condition number four, which is both pairs of opposite angles are congruent. And for number five, we are talking about diagonals and bisectors. So we have two keywords right here, bisectors or bisect each others. So bisect means it cuts our line segment into two congruent parts. So how are we going to visualize it using symbols in a parallelogram? So let's have our parallelogram right here. And this can be considered to be parallelogram if condition number five is satisfied, which is the diagonals bisect each other. So let's say that this is our first diagonal and this is our other diagonal. Bisect means cutting our line segment into two equal parts. So that means this should be equal and this should be equal because we have a bisector right here. And this is also considered to be a bisector of this longer lines right here. And if they are also congruent, then condition number five is satisfied, which is the diagonals bisect each other. And in this particular diagram, so that is our diagonal bisector. And we know that if our bisector cuts the line segment into equal parts, it's considered to be a proper bisector. And the other lines as well should also bisect that line. So that means condition number five will also be satisfied. And for the last condition, we're seeing supplementary and consecutive angles. And we should know the definition of supplementary and consecutive angles. So if one angle is supplementary to both its consecutive angles, that means that our parallelogram is considered to be our quadrilateral is considered to be a parallelogram. And to be able to visualize that better, so let's say we have here our quadrilateral consecutive angles is, let's say this is angle X, Y, Z, and W. Consecutive is angle W and angle Z. They are considered to be consecutive because they're right next to each other. But angle X and angle Z are not consecutive. They are opposite. So we just need to prove that our consecutive angles are supplementary angles. Then it will be considered to be a parallelogram. Now, what is supplementary angles? Supplementary angles, for a quick visual would be, let's say this is our line segment and it forms an angle, angle one and angle two. Angle one and angle two are supplementary to each other because it forms a 180 degrees or a straight line. So since angle one and angle two are equal to 180, they are called supplementary. And to visualize it to this particular parallelogram, so this is our parallelogram, you are seeing the red little corner, two corners, the left side and the right side. This is the left side and this is the right side. And if we put them together, we're able to form a straight angle. And that straight angle is considered to be 180 degrees. Therefore, we're able to satisfy condition number six. And that is how we articulate and use this in our proving problem later on in our geometry lessons for quadrilateral to be considered to be a parallelogram. So let's have some examples on how we use these conditions for this quadrilateral. We are still not sure if this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. We need to satisfy one of the six conditions. So let's start with the given information for our first quadrilateral, which is LMNO. So in this quadrilateral, we know that LM and ON are parallel. It's given in this particular symbol. And we're also given the expressions on the measurements of line segment LM and line segment ON, given by 4x minus 2 and x plus 7. So let's start proving that this is a parallelogram, but by making sure that the opposite sides are both parallel and congruent. So we know that they are parallel, we're just not sure if it's congruent. So let's use our handy dandy marker and whiteboard so we can find the measurement of line segment LM, given that LM is 4x minus 2 and that the value of x is equal to 3. So by substituting the value of x, which is 3, we have 4 times 3 minus 2 and we have 12 minus 2. So line segment LM is equal to 10. Now let's see if line segment ON is going to be similar or congruent to LM. So line segment ON is given by x plus 7, and we know that x is equal to 3. So 3 plus 7 is equal to 10. Therefore, line segment ON is also equal to 10. So LM and ON are the same length. So instead of spelling out congruent, we can use this symbol for congruency. So now we're able to prove that this quadrilateral is also a parallelogram because we know from the given that they are parallel, LM and ON. We just need to prove that they are congruent. And we're able to prove that by calculating the value of length LM and ON using the expression and the given value of x. So this is how we state our parallelogram by satisfying condition number two, which is one pair of opposite sides is parallel and at the same time congruent, which is what we're seeing in our visual in this particular problem. So that's example number two, proving that this quadrilateral is parallelogram by satisfying condition number two. So let's have example number two, and let's prove that this quadrilateral is parallelogram by satisfying our condition, one of the conditions that we have. So we have angle A, B, D, C. So these are angle A, B, C, D, and we have its measurements. The measurements is not yet complete because all we're seeing are expressions, 8x degrees, 10y minus 2 degrees, 9y plus 9 degrees, and x squared minus 9 degrees. And we know that x is equal to 9 and y is equal to 11. So let's find the measurements of angle B, A, B, C, and D by substituting the value of x, which is 9, and y is equal to 11. So the measurement of angle A is equal to 8x degrees. Now we know that x is equal to 9. So all we need to do is to multiply 8 and 9, which is equal to 72. So now we're able to find measurement of angle A, which is 72 degrees. So we're able to compute for the first angle. Now let's move on to the second angle, which is measurement of angle B, given by the expression 10y minus 2 degrees. And we know that y is equal to 11, not square, but degrees. So 10 times 11 is 110 minus 2 degrees. So we'll have 110 minus 2 is going to be 108 degrees. And this is going to be the measurement of angle B. And are we correct for this angle? Yes, it's 108. So now let's proceed to the measurement of angle C, given by the expression x squared minus 9. And this are, of course, in degree measure. So x is equal to 9. So 9 squared minus 9. And we know that 9 squared is equal to 81. And we subtract 9 from 81. So we know that the measurement of angle C is 81 minus 9, which is also equal to 72 degrees. Are we correct? Yes, it is indeed 72 degrees. So now we're left with our last angle, which is the measurement of angle D, given by the expression 9y plus 9. And y is 11, so 9 times 11 plus 9. And if we do the math, we know that 9 times 11 plus 9 is going to equal to 108. So this is congruent to angle B. So in this case, we're able to prove that measurement of angle A is congruent. We're not seeing it in my calculation or in my writing right here, but let's say we're going to prove it in this parallelogram. So since we are seeing that the opposite angle, angle A and angle C, are both equal to 72 degrees, so we're able to get closer to proving that they are parallelogram, or this is a parallelogram. We just need to prove that the other opposite sides are also congruent, which we know is correct because angle B and angle D are both 108 degrees. So by using our six conditions, we're able to prove condition number 4, which means this quadrilateral is indeed a parallelogram because we're able to satisfy that specific condition in our definitions or in our conditions for parallelogram. So this is how we're able to mathematically prove that a quadrilateral is indeed a parallelogram. And for your challenge, let's see who's going to be able to answer problems 1, 2, 3, and 4, given that we have the parallelogram, allegedly, because we don't know if this is still a parallelogram, but we're going to prove that if you can answer problems 1, 2, 3, and 4. So comment it down below and let's see what letters, 4 letters between A and D, are the letters that we are looking for the correct answer for this particular question. And this is our lesson on geometry, specifically in understanding the conditions that will help you identify if your quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So to be able to prove that, we just need to be familiar with the six conditions, and these conditions, together with your skill on writing your symbols from the words that we're using in geometry, you'll be able to use this information and skill to be able to learn how to prove some proofs in geometry that we're going to be talking about in the future. So this is Dr. E, and see you again next time. Bye!